What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video, man. So today we are reacting to Akon featuring Biggie featuring Tupac Ghetto Remix for the very first time. So if you got any other videos you want to react to, comment them down below, man. I'll definitely get to it. But without further ado, let's get right to this in 3, 2, 1.
People look at you like you's the user, selling drugs to all the losers, mad Buddha abuser. But they don't know about your stress-filled day. Baby on the way, mad bills to pay. That's why you drink Tangeray, so you can reminisce and wish you wasn't living so devilish.
Damn, come on, Big. Why am I relating so heavy to this shit right now? Because that shit true. Sometimes you ain't got no fucking choice. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. For real. Motherfuckers don't care about you. They don't care that you got a baby on the way. They don't care that you living in poverty. They don't give a fuck that your bills is past due. They don't care, bro. They don't care. All they care about is he's black. We gotta arrest him. He's going to prison. I don't care if he got a family to feed. We gonna get him. They don't give a fuck about you. Fuck. They gonna look at that as an excuse, like, oh, you got a kid? I don't give a fuck. Hey, I got kids too. But you got a whole ass job with a pension, with a 401k, and I'm talking about a police officer, and you arresting this man for trying to feed his family.
Remember, I was just like you, smoking blunts with my crew, flipping over 62s, cause GED wasn't B-I-G, I had to get P-A-D, that's why my mom hate me. She was forced to kick me out, no doubt, then I figured out, niggas went for 20 down south. Packed up my tools for my raw power move, Glock 19 for casket and flower moves. For Trump's trying to stop my flow, and what they don't know will show on the autopsy. Went to see Poppy, to cop me a brick, asked for some consignment, he wasn't trying to hear it. Smoking mad Newports, cause I'm doing court for an assault that I caught in Bridgeport, New York. Catch me if you can, like the gingerbread man. You better have your gat in hand, cause man, you better have your gat in hand.
Better have your gat in hand, plus cuz man. You better have your gat in hand, cuz man. You feel me though? Like, I got more to lose than you do. So if you trying to kill me, nigga, I'ma kill you too. Huh? We just gonna die together, goddammit. You feel me though? Like, that shit real. Especially coming from the ghetto. Poor people killing poor people, bro. Like, huh? Come on.
These streets remind me of quicksand. When you're on it,
Akon is a fucking legend, bro.
With the toolie on the waistline, just got about the bingo estate time. Teeth marks on my back from the canine. Dark memories of when there was no sunshine. Cause they said that I would make it. I remember like yesterday. Yeah. Holding on to what God gave me. Cause that's the life when you're living.
And it's crazy too, because when you grow up like that, when you grow up fucked up, when you grow up in poverty, when you grow up in the ghetto, it's nothing to look forward to. You don't see a future for yourself. You don't see a future for your kids. You don't even know if you're gonna have kids. You don't see nothing going for you. But like, damn, I know I'm gonna end up in jail. I know I'm gonna die soon, because that's all I see that's around me. All I see is the dope man coming up, hopping out the car. I see him all flashy with the baddest bitch in the hood, and he about to take her out and shit. I want to be like that. And next week, that's the same nigga that's on the news because he got shot and killed. You feel what I'm saying? So now you don't know what to do. Now you moving. Like, what I'm going to do, man? Like, what I'm going to do? Bro, it's sad. You can't even be a fucking kid. You fucking adult at 10 years old. Like, how is that? Talking about I got to go get a job. I can't even go outside and have fun with my friends. Like, I got to go help you pay bills. And you got a whole nigga in the crib laid up. Huh? Okay, mama. Okay, daddy.
Believe that you can achieve. Just look at me. Against all odds, though life is hard. We carry on. Living in the projects, broke with no lights on. So all the seas that follow me, protect your essence. Born with less, but you still precious, still precious.
This is my part.
Another day.
Two techs to take over this project. They call him Two Techs, he told Two Techs. And when he start the bus, he like to ask who's next. At last, I'm literally lounging black, sitting back, counting double-digit thousand stacks. See who got smoked, what rumors were spread. Last I heard, I was dead, I was dead, I was dead, I was dead, I was dead.
Another day in. Hey, all I'm saying though too is if you able to make money and get into a little bit of money, invest that in yourself, invest that in something so you can multiply your shit. Because I'm telling you, money runs out quicker than you think. Because you need money to do every fucking thing. You need money to live, goddamn. You need money to survive. So if you come into some, please invest that in something, bro. I can't tell you what, but it's a million things that you can invest your money into that you can do instead of keep making the same situation or what, putting yourself in the same situation over and over and over again. Keep putting yourself down over and over and over again. Keep falling over and over and over again. Keep showing your kids like, damn, mama, daddy, they, I can't even get this new bike for Christmas type shit. You know how sick that is, how sad that is. Who wanna feel like that? Who wanna feel that low, bro? Cause these kids ain't asked to be here. I ain't asked to be here. You ain't asked to be here. But hey, sometimes you gotta make the best out of your situations, bro. For real.
Drama, I would never wish death on nobody, you know what I'm saying? Cause ain't no coming back from that.
You see how real Big was, bro? How real Big was, how real Pac was. I wish they was, you know, could have came together and made amends and all that shit. But sometimes, you know, when you got it made up in your head, like these niggas really tried to set me up and kill me, it ain't no coming back from that either. But even like the Wu-Tang, I can't remember which members it was, but two of the Wu-Tang members, they was beefing heavy. One of them shot up his crib with his brothers in the crib and all that shit, you know what I mean? And they cool. They in it. You know what I'm saying? They just had to squash the beef because it don't be worth your life. Just like Big said, I won't wish death on nobody. That ain't nothing you can come back from. You can't come back from that shit. So why would I wish that on you, bro? I don't hate nobody that much. I don't think about nobody that much. But yeah, they was fucking pioneers. They was legends, man. And you don't realize that shit until you be like, damn, like, we really made this shit happen. We really got a whole West Coast, East Coast beef going on, and it ain't even like that, bro. We just popping motherfuckers who just come from two different sides of the world. Rest in peace, Pac, man. I wonder how they got that picture. That picture at the end when he was in Vegas and shit with Suge and A.N. I wonder how they got that picture, though. Because it was like maybe a street camera or something. I don't know. But, hey, if y'all enjoyed that, go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, man. I truly appreciate it. Catch me in my next video. Peace out.